Bodega Boys.
Hey, get in order, get in order, get in order, all right? Have your IDs out. Remember, you can't come to this pool party if you're not vaccinated. Like we said on the IG, it says right there, if you're not vaccinated, you can't get in, all right?
Fuck
that goes
you
for
mean.
All of y'all. That goes for all of y'all. Y'all chicks in the back with the ballerina slippers.
Y'all fuck out of here.
You guys, you African American guys
what are you
with the chains.
About?
You Spanish those, guys with the cuts in your eyebrows. You have your vaccination cards open. All right, step up. Bro. My guy, you got a vaccine card? What's up? What's up?
Nah, I got my ID right here. You know what I'm saying? Boom. I don't got no Rona. I'm good. You know what I'm saying? I'm going there.
About how do I know? How do I know you don't got the Rona? Where's your vaccine card?
You know what I'm saying? I mean, first of all, like, do you have the vaccine?
I actually do. I was
oh,
the first
oh, so you just, vaccine. You would just be doing whatever. Like, if a doctor says to do something, you're just going to do it. Because they a doctor and they know science and shit like that. You just going to do it?
No, I had to get vaccinated because I had to take care of my mother. Because when I'm not working the door at this nightclub, I'm actually a healthcare worker in the daytime. Because, you know, I'm altruistic like that. But back to you, you nugget. Where's your vaccine card? We ain't here for this. We're not going with the back and forth, my man. Yo, big man.
Yo,
unvaccinated big man. Step to the right. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Next.
Yeah, but
young lady. Oh, you look like you're from the Bronx.
Hey,
how you doing, man?
Oh shit, we about to be late.
How you doing? You look very cute.
Yo, hey, how you doing? Yo, the hookah's 30 cash, right? They told me 30 cash. It better not be 50.
30 cash. That's a special for y'all, cause I know you kind of cheap, because you got that fashion. Can I see your vaccine card though?
Yeah, we live. My what?
Oh, your vaccine card. When you got it after the two shots.
Like the one, from school. Like the one that I bought from school. That has like rubella and shit like that. And measles.
Yeah, that's not even close to what I asked for. So we're gonna do this again. Do you have your vaccination card? Because if you don't, you can't.
Like from when I was a baby, like from my pediatrician, like for I could go to school and shit like that.
No, I mean from like this year, like after you got either the Pfizer, Johnson & Johnson, or the.
Oh, you talking about the COVID shit? You talking about the Rona shit?
Yeah, as you people would say, DK. Yes, the COVID shit.
Yo, let me ask you something.
Oh, here we go.
Are you a doctor?
I'm a doctor when I be numbing that pussy, but I mean, other than that, I'm not a medical doctor.
Listen, so basically what you're telling me is just because you saw on TV or you heard a doctor telling you that you should put this shit inside your body, you're going to do it?
Let me ask you something. Have you put things inside your body for less?
I mean, listen, that's neither here nor there.
That's here. That's right now. Because right here, right now is the present. And the present we're talking about was your vaccination card. You don't have your vaccination card. Big man to the left. Big man to the left. What did Beyonce and her friend say? To the left. Bye.
Everything on a box. Oh, my God.
Everything in a box to the left.
Now they mad, bro.
All right. I'm sorry, y'all. We have reached capacity. Okay?
Hey,
it's full capacity.
Bro. Bro, can I get in, bro? I got my card right here.
So are you injecting yourself right now?
Yeah, bro. Look, I'm taking a shot right now. It says Moderna. I wrote Moderna on the fucking needle.
It's written in Sharpie.
We need
a bus to the front. We need a bus to the front. Someone get some Narcan, and he has a wrist ID. It says Ovaltine as well. Oh, my God. Oh, God. Oh, can't even deal with this. I'm going to quit and start a podcast.
Bro.
He's alive.
Huh. What's Jeez. Bro? Can I go inside now? It's a new episode, bro. I want to go listen.
It's a new episode. How many fingers am I holding up?
244. You're doing 244s.
You know what? Cancel the bus. He's doing all right. Everybody. You know what? You can go on my side, my guy. You're all right.
Yeah! Let's fucking go! Fuck you assholes! Oh, you guys made fun of me because I smell bad and I fucking peed on myself on the train? Guess who's getting in the club? Me! Not you! You fucking schmoes! Go get your fucking shot, you piece of shit!
That's right. Enjoy the club, sir, and do the drop.
Yeah! Do the fuck! Yeah! Bodega Boys! I'm in outrage! Woo!
You're listening to The Audio Art, the most dangerous podcast in the universe. Do the drop.
Episode episode 244 of the world's most dangerous podcast, coming to you live from the Zoom Zoom room on top of the Standard Hotel. You know the vibes. We are recording to you live from the pool.
From the pool at Le Bain.
Pool at Le Bain.
We're
currently soaking in fresh vibes of COVID-20. You know the vibes.
Yeah, baby.
All COVID-20 is...
I swallowed an empty bag of Coke.
All COVID-20 is COVID-19, but with Axe body spray.
Yo, that's like, it. Am I some LA looks hair gel? You feel me? That's it.
Oh, going out on a night on the town, which is starting at 6 p.m. on a Wednesday. Like, ooh,
yeah,
that's when the lookers are out. You know.
Yeah.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying? DMV gets out at 5 o'clock. Hit that Applebee's by 6, baby.
There you go. Get yourself an electric blue and fold up your Skechers. You know the vibes. As always, sponsored by Cash App and Tyler Perry. So, you know.
He brought us to Atlanta. We're in Atlanta right now doing this from his mansion. Thank you, Tyler.
That's right. We are in the same way he gave, what's her name? Meghan Markle.
Yes.
In the house. He was like, here, take a podcast studio. He was like, all right, cool. Thank you, Tyler. Thank you, Tyler. Sounds like a gospel song, but it's a very specific gospel song, so only very specific black people know it. And when they reference it on Twitter, you're like, what are they talking about? And everyone else is like, what?
I don't know.
But then you got like people from Arkansas and rural Texas. They're like, oh, that's my grandma's favorite song. You're like, okay.
All right.
Thank you, Tyler. Thank you. And they're like, remember when McCurkin played this? You're like, what? I'm like, that's not. Shit ain't on Spotify. Shit ain't on YouTube.
I was not expecting this in the Kirk Franklin versus the Winans.
Exactly.
Versus.
Questlove has a special Japanese rare remix featuring prints of it. You're like, ooh.
Whoa, wow.
Ooh, wow.
White label.
Wow. Oh, good times. Yeah. Good times. Are Versus done? Since like now niggas just opened up? Since they should do a Johnson & Johnson versus Pfizer versus. Yeah.
This nigga got blood clots.
There you go. Bah, 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 bah. Just a sound clash.
DeMarco.
Like, yo. And then it could
just turn into a URL smack battle.
They could just bring out different people who were vaccinated with that specific brand of the vaccine.
Yo, straight up.
But those people would have to be available. Then what if you're going to have people who don't really got hits cropping up? Like, yo.
Yo, listen, don't shoot the messenger. But I'm going to just go out on a limb and say that most battle rappers are not vaccinated.
That's fair.
I feel, like how... I feel like a battle rapper will hit you with the, yo, that's that 5G. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They put a chip in you, my nigga. They put a chip inside you, you know what I mean? So they can track your movements. I was like, thank you, MC Shazam, but my iPhone is already tracking all my movements. The government knows where I am already. Okay? Thank you.
Well, also, if you're a battle rapper and you get the vaccine, you're opening yourself up for the punchline. Someone was like, you got two shots and you don't get some more. And you're just gonna be like, yo, he ended you.
Oh, shit. And you know they're going to say with that stupid, like stunted delivery. He's like, I put two shots in your ass, like Moderna.
Wait. Yeah, it's like, oh.
And then all his mans that know the line because he wrote it are there.
They're like, yeah. And you gotta do that thing where you get real close on a person. And
yeah,
like,
yeah. Wait, like, if your bills and your hat are not touching, are you even battling?
I don't like that. I don't like that because that's big high school, junior high school.
Yo,
you go first.
Do something.
You go first.
Do something. Do something. I ain't gonna get suspended because of you. That was the Bunzini way out of a fight. And now I get suspended because of you. What the fuck do you mean? You're suspended a week off.
I remember I got into a fight with my friend. Like, we were boys, but we got into, you know, you get into a stupid physical fight with your boy. Yeah. Like, first period. Bro, we didn't even get to, like, throw punches. The fight was, like, maybe 15 seconds long. We had to spend the next three periods in the fucking dean's office waiting for the dean to make time to yell at us. He had no idea why we were even there. And I was like, we sitting on the bench next to each other. I was like, yo, my fault, man. He was like, nah, I was wilding. And I was like, to the lady, like, we apologize. Can we go? And they're like, no, you got to talk to the dean. I was like, shit.
Yo, fam, the deans are the worst. Yo, the deans in my school were the worst. And Clint were the worst because homie called me doing graffiti one time and chased me. And I'm like, yo, my first instinct, if you in high school, you see the dean, you run because you're doing something foul. So homie chased me and he tripped and he fell. And that was, that's what, that was, it was all over for me from there. Cause he was mad as fuck. And when the motherfucker had me up, I was sitting in that office, motherfucker suspended me for damn near a month. I was like, yo, what did I do? He's like, yo. I was like, I got suspended for a month for right and catching a tag? He's like, no, nigga, because you made me fall down the steps. And I look doofy. That's why.
You could never, there was like, shout out to Chucky, the security guard at Lehman who had a bum knee. So everyone knew if Chucky was chasing you, you had to turn around and you had to just run at him at full speed and then do a juke move. And he always was just like, ah! And that's how you got away. Just come at that. Because he was like going to try to catch you. And at the last minute, you just be like, you just hit him with the mellow Euro step, like, the jabs. And he was like, I'm out of here. And all the time, the wildest part is like, if they had just let people into the classrooms, you wouldn't have to be chasing. Security guards would not be chasing us. Like, if I didn't want to come back to school, I would have just stayed out for the whole lunch period. Now I'm 5 minutes late. You're not going to let me back in the class. And now I'm just going to spend the whole period running from security. That's fun. Yeah. That's fun. Security's not gonna catch me, by the way.
Not at all. You know? I'm like, yo, dog, when you don't like, I feel like deans and security don't understand. When you're 15 years old, evading deans and security feels like a James Bond mission. Like you are here, you feeling like motherfucking. I was gonna Alex Cross.
You're doing Mission Impossible shit. Like they don't know about like running into the staircase, jumping over the staircase wall, and then laying flat. Uh-huh. So then you hear them go down the staircase, and you come back up, and then they got another unit. That's looking down. So now they're on the far side of the floor and they see you. So now you're running. You have to run to the other side before they see you. But then you zig back. You just do it. Oh, man.
It's Jason Bourne shit, bro. You over there hopping over handrails and shit?
Exactly.
Doing parkour?
Just jumping off of, just skipping whole flights of steps when you run in. And then if they do catch you, you just run to the first floor and run out the building. So.
Bye. See you tomorrow.
What do we gain here? We gain nothing. So. Sad but fun. Tales of New York City public schools. Oh, you know the vibes.
Yo, all you know high school vibes. Kids listen to this. Do this when school starts again.
You know the vibes. Yeah. All right, summer. Well, shout out to us. We just we did an amazing job calling the Mayweather fight.
Yes, we did. You know what I'm saying? Not to pat ourselves on the back, but we did. You know what I'm saying? Can't argue with facts.
Top notch, probably the best part of the night. Better than Amigo's performance. Better than the actual fight. I dare someone to say we weren't. Also, shout out to anybody that is in a similar profession to ours, but wasn't asked to do the Mayweather fight. So instead, they were at home commenting about our performance on Twitter.
You're being very generous saying that we're in the same field. You're being very generous. I got to give you that. You know what I'm saying?
To put it, we have a track coming out with
diplomatic.
Drake. We have the Bodega Boys have a track coming out with Drake, and it's called Man's Down Sad. And we'd like to dedicate that to our guy. So, you know.
Yeah. You know, we some certified lover boys, and you a certified hater, motherfucker.
Certified hater. I got the certified lover boy. I got the little heart shaved in my crotch, bro, right in my pubic hairs. All right. We're not certified lover boys for Drake. We're certified lover boys from Chaba Bronx. Mr. Lover Man.
Chaba.
That's pure Jamaican love. You're like, oh, I love you. He's like, I'm going to kill you with it. You're like, oh,
yeah.
All right. Kill you with it.
Yo, shout out to Dancehall for making like mad, like hardcore sex sound like mad, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, every time I listen to Rapper Shop, I'm just like, yo. And he's like, "Me cocky longer than me nine." I'm like, "Yes." Mm-hmm. Compare your penis to a gun. Yes.
That's the only romantic. Way you could do it, bro.
I'm like, "Yo, it's mad romantic."
That's only way you could do
Caribbean
it, man.
Romance.
Listen, if you have sex with someone and they're alive afterwards, you did not have good Jamaican sex with them.
No, no, no.
Having sex with a Jamaican is like having sex with a praying mantis. You're just like,
it's rolling
you hope at
dice.
The end of it, you still got your head, you know? It's just how it goes, bro. It's just how it goes. To quote Tupac, yeah. That's just the way it is.
It is. Oh my God. That's my least favorite Tupac song. And I'm not even a Tupac fan like that, but it's just let me walk it back. It's not that I don't like the song. I don't like the people that like that song. You know what I'm saying? Because it's too positive. I thrive off negativity. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like that's the type of song that a teacher would throw on, like a guidance counselor, mm-hmm. when you go into their room and shit. Like, yo, I'm cool.
Point you in the right direction. Like,
yeah, yo, like, yo, I'm cool. Hey, you know about Pac? I'm sorry, Tupac Shakur. I don't know if you know about him. You might be a little young. I'm like, yo, fam, no.
I think the worst Tupac song is the one he made for the guy that died in Fast and Furious. That one. It's been a long
time. It should be a friend. That was Khalifa. Yo, he's probably still eating off that.
That was Tupac.
That was Tupac.
No, I was mad high in L.A., and I was like, imagine if Tupac made this. It'd be different. Yeah. You talking about my enemies and shit, I guess?
Like, yo, it's about all my Hennessy's.
And we ride on our enemies.
I did not see the sign that said S-T-O-P.
I was listening to that song, though. That was like, I've never liked that song, but I was like, I can see why people, it's cute. It's like explaining what a friendship is, like. I get that. Is it something I want to be in a bar listening to? No, that's just mad depressing. Like
mad depressing.
Like, yo, I'm having a good time. Let's think about some dead people I used to know.
Yeah. Let's go. Mortality.
Yeah.
Oh God. If you're scared of your own death, put your hands up. If you're scared of your own death, put your hands up.
You see death. Death is doing the wild dance with the sickle. Hey. Go, Dad. Fuck it up, Death. Fuck it up, Dad.
Nigga just spinning the sickle.
He's doing the Death is doing the woo dance. Like, yo. Oh. Fuck it up. Fuck him up. He's doing the mop. Like, mop. Oh man, no! It's sad. It's so sad.
Damn.
Oh,
sick, sad. It's a sick, sad world.
Sick, sad world.
Yo.
Speaking of sick and sad, let's see some things that have happened since we've last been on the air. The Knicks got eliminated from the playoffs, but we're okay with that because time has passed. And you know what?
We had a good time. House one anyway. We had a good run. I'm saying
it's like we enjoyed it. You know what? It's like divorcing a chick and she takes all your money, but you had good sex. You're like, you know what?
Yeah. You know
it worked
what?
Out.
It's fine. I still got like 12 sex tapes that we made. It's cool. I exactly. Did these. You know what I'm saying? It's
she said her favorite character in Casino was Ginger. I should have known. You know. So.
I knew it.
You know. I knew it. I knew you couldn't trust this broad. She was sending guys on Twitter. She was sending them money. It wasn't even like they wasn't sending her money. She was sending them money. Who does that?
What the fuck? It was like the opposite of FinDom.
She was subscribing to men's OnlyFans. Who does that? That's disrespectful. If you find out your girl is subscribed to a guy's OnlyFans.
OnlyFans? Yo. And it's a regular nigga too. It's not like some Pino dude.
Yeah.
It's not like a dude who's like, yo, I shave, I wax my chest every day. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like I got a ring light. It's just a random bozo in like Queens jerking off into a cell phone camera. Yo, I'll be furious.
This nigga just beating his meat at red lights? That's what you paying for?
What is this? I can hear the wipers.
That's our kids' college money. What are you doing? He's beating his meat during the playoff games. I can hear Doris Burke in the background. Come on. Yeah.
He's like, you know, he's got an excellent handle. And the way he handles the ball. Yo, the nigga handles his own balls.
The way he handles the ball is nothing compared to the way that KD and Kyrie handled going to Brooklyn Nets. My God, I mean, it was just amazing. They just took a team that was going nowhere and just turned it around. And I've never seen anything like that. I mean, just add James Harden and KD. And the team was basically on the level of broke. And then they came and they raised it. They're the new messiahs of basketball. No one has done what they've ever done. It's just, you love to see it. And they're probably more important than the first responders of 9/11 or the essential workers in COVID. No, that was Doris Burke. I watched Doris Burke. Doris Burke was given the full throttle. Dick flew solo to the Nets one game. I was like, yo, Doris.
Yeah, enough. Enough is enough.
Enough. Like, come on.
Basta.
Yeah, right? No mas. I think it's more egregious because we're New Yorkers, so we've been following this whole narrative. And I get it. If you're not from New York, you have not had the Nets on the news every night and everything. But the way she's talking about it, she's making it seem like KD and Kyrie saved some people in 9/11.
and restarted America in Brooklyn. And I'm like, oh, bam! I'm like, okay, relax.
Yeah. KD and Kyrie ended apartheid in South Africa. Exactly. We should talk about the motherfuckers. I'm like, yo, what are you doing?
She's like, the 1619 project is really good, but they left out the part where KD and Kyrie feed the slaves, and you're like, whoa, 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 hey, whoa, hey, whoa, hey.
Whoa, wait, hey, hey, hey. What? A- Hold up. Listen, I know they told us his story, you know what I'm saying, but I missed that part.
Oh, man. But it's the same way if you when you play NBA 2K, if you play as a Knicks and you allow the commentary, they be shitting on the Knicks. To the point you can't even enjoy the game. They're like, well, the team has seen some better. I'm like, yo, fam, now that literally has nothing to do with the exhibition game I'm playing. Also, because the Knicks have a little creative player called Desus Nicia, who is 99% on all his sliders. So if you allow him to take his logo shots with his sunglasses on, I can make this game, all right? We're up by 60 in the first. Let's go.
Yo, man, I'm telling you right now, 6'2", 215-pound shooting guard out of Fordham University, Joel Martinez, is dropping 98 points every single game.
Listen, they're like, how is he 7... They're like, how is he 7'4" and he has such a his dribble is so tight. I was like, yeah, bro, you know, he grew up in the Bronx. You know,
he was a guard, and then he had a growth spurt.
Exactly, it makes sense. They're like, he wears sunglasses every game. I'm like, it's his thing.
That's his, you know. It's like, that's his
thing. You know, leave it alone. Oh, shout out to creative character. Nothing worse than you have to like a creative character. You get kind of close to you, but it's not.
Yeah,
just like you, because like all the characters of me in the Division look like me, but definitely if I lived during the Division. Just like mad rough, mad furry braids, just that's angry.
Who got fuzzy corals and a $1.50?
Yeah.
And mad crow's feet, looks mad stressed all the time.
Now that we've done a year of the pandemic, we need to go back and recreate the Division, but make it exactly like a year of the pandemic. And that shit is going to be mad boring and mad anticlimactic. They're going to be like, here's your mission, go to the supermarket. Wait online to get inside.
Yeah, like, yo, you know I got the little dots? Yo,
yeah.
Disable security lock on laundry detergent. Purchase Tide. Purchase toilet paper. Self-checkout.
They're like, there's Clorox wipes located 492 feet away. And you got to like follow the line. But the bus is shut down and there's no subway. And as you're walking, you're hearing people. You remember when people doing the rumors? They was like, yeah, my cousin works at the CIA, and they said they're gonna blow up all the bridges in New York, so New York is like isolated from the rest of the country. So you know, pass that on. And people was putting it on Instagram, like, "Yo, this is facts. Pass it on."
Yo, yeah. Facts. Yeah.
They was like, "Yo, DK, they gonna shoot all the Puerto Ricans, like, to stop because they drink Corona. So you know, watch out for that."
Yo. Oh my god. Yo, remember when lived the Division for a year. The boring part of the Division for a year. Super. We're just sitting home crafting.
Remember the beginning when Kerry Hilson posted about 5G with her full chest and just left it up all night on Twitter? Like, that's what we were dealing with.
Yep.
Oh man. Also, shout out to a lot of you people that were talking about COVID is caused by 5G. Are real quiet right now. Mm. Real quiet. Mm.
Very quiet. Mm. I wonder why. Maybe because COVID is not caused by 5G.
That's why the barbershop. See, because I learned how to cut my own hair. I don't have to go to the barbershop. But if I was there, I'd be like, this nigga thought it was 5G. All right? This fucking AT&T ass nigga. This T-Mobile ass nigga.
Motherfucker.
This OmniPoint ass nigga.
Yo, I'm not taking advice from nobody that pays for their cell phone bill in cash at a kiosk.
Wow. We're gonna get rid of the problematic light and get the classes light. Like, yo. Yo. This nigga's engaging in class warfare. Listen, paying for your phone per week or per month, it builds character. All right. Nothing feels like, yo, I made it, then flattening out some singles to slide into the machine. Listen, like, yeah. That's on me, buddy.
Yo, I feel like my ex started listening to the podcast because I feel like she'd be subbing me in her stories. But that was a direct sub to her because I used to be on the T-Mobile store for them, and this bitch was paying her phone bill in 20s at the little kiosk. Listen, I'm like, you bum bitch.
Listen, I used to, when I worked in the strip club, I used to pay my rent in 20s, and I'd come home at like, on a good night, I'd get home like 5:45, which if you do the math, there's no way I legally could have gotten from Manhattan to the Bronx by following the speed limit at that time if the club closed at like 5:30, but don't worry about that. Anyway, hey. I get to the check cashing place, and I basically just slide them all my rent in 20s. Underneath, and the lady was like, what the f-? And I was like, let me get two money orders, mommy. Because that's too much money for one money order. I've been here before. Let's go. You know how it
Let's
goes.
Let's go. Come on. You know the vibes.
But that was always a good feeling because if we had a big night at the, if we had a big, like at the first of the month, those parties, you could pay your rent off of one night. Like,
oh, yeah.
It used to be so sweet, bro. And then, you know, with a little extra money from, you know, selling talcum. You know, you got the time, bro. You go to the diner and you're like, you know what? I want white bread and whole wheat. And they're like,
that's right.
How I like that? You got gyros? They're like, this is IHOP.
What do you? Yes, we do. This is the sign of your IHOP. So yes, we do have gyros.
You want gyro? You know what? Matter of fact, we got some lobsters in the back. You want me to bring those back over here, funny guy? That's the last thing you want me to call a funny guy at a diner.
Like, yo, the dude calls you funny guy in a diner, they're jerking off in your meal. I'm sorry to tell you right now.
Listen, if it's Waffle House, they might just fight you outside. If I fight you, I mean shoot you. So you
gotta
watch
for real. They'll fight you with a gun. Like, yo, mm-hmm. Oh, we gonna square up? They're like, nah, homie. I'm gonna put a hot one in your ass.
Waffle House, the only place you be eating, and a bullet comes up to you and be like, hey, listen, big fan. Just wanted to introduce myself. We're gonna have a run-in later tonight, but I just wanted to talk to you beforehand. Big fan of what you're doing. You know, love the Fendi tracksuit. You know, it's cool. You getting money, my nigga? I see you. Anyway, I'll see you. And also, know what your blood type is. All right, later, yo.
Peace.
I gotta go, my guy. I'll see you.
I feel like in the South, bullets are just like clippy. You know what I'm saying? And word. Like, they just pop up like, yo, hey, I'm here.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
I'm everywhere.
They have more license to use the guns. Because, like, their rules are different, so they can legally carry. But then I was thinking about it, and I was like, it probably means more when people in New York carry guns because they carry them illegally. And that's like, you're carrying it like, yo, I'm a savage. But you both end up in jail regardless.
Yeah.
So there's no, like, rhyme or reason to it. But, yeah, when you read those stories in about, like, Florida and Texas and stuff, and they're like, yo, anyone could carry a gun, in my head as a New Yorker, that just means I automatically would have to carry a gun at all times because other people carry guns.
100%. That's my thing. I'm just gonna assume that they grandma and at fucking the supermarket is packing. You know what I'm saying? So just in case there's any kind of static, to quote Jimmy Jackson from Buffalo, I do keep that thing on me too. So you come around here, you will get clapped.
Yeah, and if you got the burner on you, that changes everything. Like, if you have no gun, you'll talk things out. Like, you'd be like, all right, let's, you know, let's have a conversation. You got the burner, everything is like, what?
What?
The fuck you said?
You're not going to give me two barbecue sauces? What?
Oh, that's how you feel? On your mother? That's how you feel? Okay.
Oh,
what? All right.
Why are you reaching?
See, you can't go through life like that.
Nah,
you can't go through life.
Nah. No.
I've been the hothead at the party like that, and I've also, but I'm not hot-headed enough to go through with that. Because, like, I do the math, and it's just like, I really don't want to go to jail. Even as a young person. I was like, jail. I think Jay-Z said the best line. He was like, jail sucks because there's no bitches there. And I was like,
true.
No one, people do not point that out. Think about that. Like, everything you do, selling the drugs, buying the jewelry, buying the cars and all that. Why are you doing that? To impress women.
Yep.
To impress women. And if you want to get real, you know, it's Pride Month to impress other niggas. That's a whole nother conversation.
You know what I'm saying?
Because you know what? You're not ready for the conversation. Some of y'all niggas in the hood got crushes on other niggas and don't want to admit it.
Yep.
Some of you rappers have crushes on athletes.
Yep.
Some athletes have crushes on rappers.
Oh.
So, you know, ain't nothing wrong with that.
It's an anagram.
Call it what it is. All right?
Keep it real.
You're talking about, that's my OG. That's my homie. That's my big dog. Nah, like, nigga, you want a spoon with that nigga.
You want a spoon with that nigga?
You listen, sometimes you look at the picture of two niggas, you be like, yo, that niggas want a spoon. Ain't nothing wrong with that. If that's
it's
your homeboy, you should be. Listen,
you can
but
spoon?
If it's 16 of y'all and it's all guys and it's on one private jet, there's some spooning going on. That's all I'm saying. Okay?
Come on.
There's no reason.
You could cuddle.
Only one of y'all afforded that private jet. I don't know where the other 15 of y'all is coming from. But you know what? That's for y'all to figure out.
If I pay for this flight and I want to cuddle, you cuddling with me, nigga. I don't give a
fuck. That's right. Big spoon, back spoon, small spoon. We gotta remake. We're gonna remake Dollar Wine for Pride, and it's just gonna be different spoons. And everyone's gonna be like, "This is inappropriate." Me want
look
the
at him.
Big
every
spoon
June.
All the time.
Every June, these guys with the spoon shit trying to cash in.
Trying to cash in. Also, since it's Pride, as always, you know what we like to say here in the Bodega Verse. Happy Pride to all my gay niggas.
Yeah, make some motherfucking noise. Yo, that's hard. Make some noise for the gay niggas. Make some noise.
Make some noise for all the gay niggas. All the gay niggas, all the gay niggas, all the gay chicks, all the gay thems, everybody out there.
Everybody out there.
Everybody on the LGBTQIA spectrum.
Plus,
with all your flags.
Let's go,
baby. You know
what
I'm saying? It's your month. Be gay, do crimes, do stuff.
Yeah.
Gaily.
Be gay, do crimes.
You know? Do your thing.
Yo, be gay, do crime. Yo.
That's the rallying cry right there.
Yeah, apparently.
Be gay, do crime.
Shit. I woke up to that shit. I was just like, yo, okay. I was like, yo, a gay drill rapper should fucking come out and do that as like a single. Like, yo, be gay, do crime. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, they're probably,
fire beat.
Let's be honest. There's probably mad gay drill rappers, and we have no radar to see them.
Like openly gay.
No, like, there's definitely openly gay drill rappers, and I'm sure after this comes out, people are going to tag us, and we'll be like, oh, we never heard of this person, because think about it. Where would we be exposed to them?
Yeah.
Like,
they're not playing
on
Hot 97?
No. Also, shout out to Young M.A. She just dropped a new single. She don't miss. She just be having singles on the low. That, you know, if you fuck with her, her shit bangs. But
you know what's ill?
She don't be getting airplay and shit.
It's, you know what's ill about her? She's like a good version of Fabulous. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like where Fabulous doesn't really drop like albums, I guess, or whatever, that you're like, yo, this is going platinum. But they'll have every year, you can rest assured that there's a song that will drop that you'll be like, okay. You know what I'm saying? But not so much for Fabulous, but definitely for Young M.A.
I mean, I hear what you're saying. As a more enlightened person, I would say that she reminds me of a young Peter from the Bible, and that every book that he wrote was just inspired by the Lord and just sent you forward on a way that would make you want to go.
Yeah, I remember.
Sorry, you guys can't hear the rest of that for free to pay for more. You have to go to our new OnlyFans. Me and Mero preach.
Yes.
And it's just
only
us.
Preach.
We preach in different sexual positions. You know?
Only sermons.
By sexual positions, I mean like Bronx sexual positions. So like putting the debit card in at Target is your actual
Ooh.
Debit card.
Ooh.
Another sexual position is waiting for a table at Applebee's. And then
Ooh.
You see a couple come in, a couple that came in after you. They're getting a table before you. But because it's your girl's birthday, you don't make a scene. But then she goes, you a bitch ass nigga. She goes, you a bitch ass nigga in the car home because of that. Neither here nor
Ooh,
there.
Oh, wow.
There. Yeah. Or the traditional finger popping on the 5 train. And you got to hurry up before the train comes out the tunnel. You guys know what I'm talking about.
Yeah. You got to wait until it's done, baby.
You know the fucking vibes.
Yeah. Shout out to all my real New Yorkers that have done some type of sexual activity on the train. If you done some type of sexual activity on the train, you a real one
if you've done sexual activity on the train while playing Candy Crush.
Woo!
Woo!
Multitask. Yo, I got the peppermint.
Nice. Chocolate. Nice.
Nice.
There was a scary time in New York where everyone was playing either Candy Crush or Flappy Bird.
Oh my God.
Like everybody was just had their phone out and was just playing it. And I got caught up in it too. And then
I remember
getting caught on Candy Crush. And I was like, this is fucking impossible. And my homegirl was like, oh, go on YouTube. They have the answers. And I was like, that
What's
kind
the
of defeats
the
purpose. Right?
Yeah. I'm like, well, who can? Why? Like, I saw my kids trying to do like a walkthrough of like Mario Odyssey to get all like every single star. I was like, that's not the point of this shit.
That's not the point.
Like, the whole point of it is to, like, challenge yourself, B. Like, you know? What the fuck?
Exactly. It's like, my ex, when San Andreas dropped. Was it San Andreas? Yeah, when San Andreas dropped, she made it her mission to collect all the flowers inside the game. And that's something that, like, I would never do that. If I picked up the flowers, I'd probably beat someone to death with them. But when she played, she always stopped at the red lights. And she played very carefully. And she got all the flowers and shit. And, like, she felt so fulfilled from doing it.
Yep.
And that changed my mind. I was like, I never would think to play the game like that. And she was like, you don't have to shoot people all the time and kill people. It's like a fun game. It's a life simulation. And I was like, fuck that. Give me the jetpack.
Fuck that shit. Yeah.
I was like,
I'm doing the top. Like, call for the tank.
Let's go. Area 51 can suck my dick. I'm going in.
That's the shit. I love that shit because I'm like, yo, it's mad funny. I'm like, I'll be playing games with my kids and they want to like do missions and like, yo, I got to go through this and do that. I'm like, yo, bro, stop. Just throw in zombies. Let's go.
Yeah. Like, I was like, no, like you just want to destroy shit. And like, she used to get so stressed watching me play Grand Theft Auto because she was like, you're not playing any missions. You're just like beating up random people and running them over like, and just shooting random people. And I was like, what? I was like, that's what this game is for. Like, fuck a mission, nigga. Like, Grand Theft Auto was like, as soon as you get to a mission that's too hard, you're like, all right, we're done with this. Melee, let's go.
Let's go.
Why are you walking on the sidewalk? You don't get hit by a car.
Bing, 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 bing. Yo, it's wild because it's like, yo, we were conditioned for this. Like, I feel like, you know, we were there for, you wasn't there. We was there for the original GTA, the overhead view. Like, and you, like, they gave you points for murking motherfuckers. Like, that was literally the point of the game. It was, like, to fuck shit up. Like, I don't even remember if there was missions.
I mean, in the real world, you get points for murking people. I mean, you used to before de Blasio fucked it up.
Yeah.
You know, yeah.
Jerk.
Vote for me. I'm Eric Adams. NYPD beat the shit out of me, so I joined them. You're like, whoa.
What kind of Kevin Durant ass shit? What kind of KD ass bullshit?
Yo, know what I'm saying?
These niggas beat my ass my whole life, so I joined up.
Wow.
Get the fuck out of here, you bozo.
People forgot that because as New Yorkers, you remember this. Remember that press conference? And it was two NYPD commissioners, and it was Eric Adams, and they came out, and it was like fire, and they was kind of dancing, and it was like not one championship, not two championships, but a bunch of championships of beating people's asses. We was like, all right.
Oh, wow, okay. Yo, and it's wild to me because like all the Giuliani fans, stands, bozos, love him.
Because
he's like
a
cop lover. He's like, yo, I'm going to bring New York back. Like, we're going to eliminate graffiti and quality of life issues. I'm like, bro, don't nobody give a fuck about graffiti in New York. Like, real New Yorkers don't care. Like, they're not like, we got to get rid of this. It's a blight. Like, no, motherfucker, they don't care. They want the trains to run on time. You know what I'm saying? They want, like, fucking municipal shit to function. Stupid.
I mean,
like, motherfuckers don't care if fucking Mero has a tag on a gate that's down 3 hours a day.
But you gotta remember, Eric Adams, at one point, he was trying to make it illegal to sag your pants. People forgot what he was like, man. So, Eric Adams is just like, he's just like an older black guy. You know how he gets, when you become an older black person, you just become mad conservative.
Yeah.
Pick up your pants. Oh, white people watching you. Oh, don't wear a bonnet. Don't wear a bonnet to the airport. Like that kind of shit.
And
well, if you stop saying the N-word, this is like, if I stop saying the N-word, what does that do about systematic poverty? My nigga.
Sir.
My nigga.
Explain that.
They're like, oh, yeah. But, you know, they're like, yo, you know what it is? You know, the problem is it's these women right here. They weren't all that Fashion Nova, and that's making the men leave, and then the kids turn gay. So, you know, I want them to stop.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, Eric Adams is the type of dude, I feel like that if he became mayor of New York, like, he would make, like, Steve Harvey, like, deputy mayor or some shit like that. Like, he seems like that type of dude.
If Eric Adams became mayor, he would make, let me see, what law would he definitely pass? Something that really pisses off black people and makes white people. He would make it illegal to call police. You wouldn't be allowed to call police pigs anymore. If you called a cop a pig, if you made a oinky noise, that's a felony. That is a felony. They go through your Twitter. You know the vibes. And also, he would do a curfew at Washington Heights. But
oh, you it'd know
be,
it.
It'd be a weird curfew that starts at like 1 p.m. I'd be like, what? Like, what? What the fuck?
So, go home now.
Mm-hmm. He would probably make like a law that if the cops shoot you and you survive, you got to pay for the bullets.
Oh. Yo, yo, no, he definitely would. He definitely would. Yo, that motherfucker, it would be like insurance. Like, he'd just charge you. Like, yo, you got to pay. Just, yo, you called 911 by accident. You meant to call 311. So we're invoicing you $5,000 because the cop mm-hmm. went halfway there.
I'm going to run for mayor and I'm going to make a service called 511. And it's going to be for shit that's not 911, but it's not 311, but you feel like you need to do some shit about it, and it's just be like counselors on it. You'd be like, yo, my fucking neighbor blocked my driveway with this car. You like, yo, you really feel that way about it right now?
I mean,
like, your neighbor uses that car to get to work, and maybe she wasn't able to find parking, and she had to park it as an emergency. It's a pandemic, and she might be struggling to pay her rent. So if I call and get her car towed, she might actually kill herself. You really want that on your conscience?
Do you? You want blood on your hands?
That? I'm like, how soon will you make her kill herself? Because I can't stand that bitch. You're like, oh.
Yo, fuck that. Yeah, actually, I would love that. You know what I'm saying? So can we make that happen, like, now?
Somebody kill that old bitch.
Yo, come on. Not Miss Gladys. Yo. Motherfucker.
Can't do that.
Yo. They got another Purge movie coming out.
How many? They've had a Purge show. They've had Purge movies.
Fair. It is wild.
I've
who
never
owns
seen
that IP?
Any of those. I mean, the idea of a day in America where you could just kill anybody, that sounds very white.
Yo.
That sounds.
Sir, let's talk about
extremely
it.
Extremely white. That sounds
let's
like.
Let's talk about it.
That sounds like Columbus. That sounds like the Trail of Tears.
Yo, fam. That sounds like every. White dude with 38,000 AR-15s in his garage, mm-hmm. That's his dream come true.
Yeah.
Like, yo, I'm just going to go into every neighborhood with people that are not white and just, brah, like, and it's cool. It's legal. But, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah, motherfuckers did the purge. What the fuck are we talking about? Motherfuckers already did the purge. They ran up in the Capitol. Nothing happened. Has anybody gone to jail?
Not. No one's going to jail. That lady got killed. So, city. Listen.
I mean.
City, the Capitol boys are down one. Sorry. Think about that. Like, you see mad people. They're like, yo, we storming the Capitol. You're like, let's fucking go. You buy your ticket. You're on Twitter talking cash shit. And you're like, yo, we in here like a family. We're a gang. We got this. Where one goes, we all go. And then you get clapped. And you're like, as you die, you're like, ride for me. And they're like,
Ooh, you know what? My megabus is coming in like half an hour. And
I got that
really...
4 o'clock Amtrak, and I got, I'm hungry.
Yikes. Yeah.
Yeah, let's get out of here. Ooh.
Yeah,
ooh.
I'm gonna go grab some chicken tenders before I get on the train. All right.
Hate to see you. Hate to see you.
Bye. Keep some pressure on there.
Wow.
Motherfuckers be like, yo, don't laugh.
Nah, you can laugh. You can laugh, because you know what it is? That's definitely, because it's not like, people were just like, oh, Shorty, what was his name, Ashley, whatever. They're like, she was just like an innocent person. She was like in the armed forces. She had combat training and everything. And I'm not saying I have combat training. I am a four-star general. I, if you guys don't remember, single-handedly freed the White House from Russian oppression.
That's right.
You guys remember that? Remember mm-hmm. that? Me and my friend Ramirez, okay?
Nope.
Yeah, I forgot. Nope. You forgot what we... Mero, remember we had to save Burgertown?
Yes, that we saved Burgertown. You know what I'm saying?
Where was
smashed
our fucking
all parade? Yeah, that's right. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You know how many APVs we blew up? You
remember
know what
I'm saying? We had to walk the honey badger down the street and
yes.
like, take out the... Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And there was mad mortars falling all around us, like deafening.
No one cared about that shit.
Yeah, we nobody did, cared.
So as veterans, she should have known.
Where's our flowers?
You can't just... You know? She should have known, because what I was told is the window that she went through, before she went through it, on the floor was mad extra ammo. So she should have known she was going to a boss battle. Like,
you know what I'm saying?
That's just how it goes, bro.
You pick up the munitions, stupid. You got to plate up.
Shorty was like, wow. She was like, armor? Ammo? More guns? What could possibly go wrong? It's like,
what's around the corner? I don't know.
There was just a little arrow floating. It was like, save game here. Save game here. Oh.
Yeah.
Damn.
Sorry, Shorty. Can't load that game.
Damn.
Game over.
Remember when Call of Duty would give when you died and they just give you like the wild patriotic message to make you play again?
Yeah, like some by some random general.
They'll be like, real Americans don't die, you pussy. And you're like, oh, okay.
All right.
They'll be like, if I could, I would have killed more Japanese. And you're like,
oh. Winston Churchill. You're like, what? You said that?
I was like, I never heard this quote before. My only regret is I didn't have 3 nuclear bombs. Yo, what?
Abraham Lincoln. What? You're like, what? You're like, that don't make no sense.
I freed them, but nah, you know how it goes. Abraham Lincoln. You're like, whoa.
Yo, Call of Duty is such terrible, like, colonial ass, like, America is the greatest propaganda. Because, like, no matter what other, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, country or whatever you're fighting against, it's always, like, opposition forces. It's never like, yo, you know what I mean? Like,
I mean, if they really wanted to make one, they would make a Call of Duty about that capital insurrection. And yo, have you... They DLC? Would never make that. They would never, ever, ever make that.
Yo, if they make that, I would nut. I play that shit every single day, bro. And the nigga with the Viking, he's like a boss. The Viking helmet guy, you gotta make your way to the chamber and just clap.
You meant that online? Niggas playing that like Fortnite? Oh, shit. Nigga assassinate Mike Pence and do the Fortnite dance? Are you?
How you break Mike Pence and be like,
is this nigga dancing a Doja Cat? Wow. They were like, Mike Pence would be E-limbs. You're like, oh.
He's been E-limbed. They just be like, renegade.
It's like, yo. You say over his course, like, I wear all my jewelry when I go to the bodega. They're like, ah, shit, B.I.B.I. I was gonna say we're gonna get in trouble for that, but the people who actually did not get in trouble.
So how can we get in trouble?
We'll be fine. Okay.
We could make a video game based around that, based on true events, with the emotes at the end after you catch a body.
Them niggas getting it in over there, like yo,
and you just sitting there like, wanna see me do my dance in these $1,000 pants? Don't disrespect me on my man. Blame, whole lot of choppers on your ass.
Oh shit, they got him. Oh man. But it's June. Shout out to everyone for not, remember last year when everyone was doing all the fireworks and we didn't know where they were coming from? And then people were saying it's from the government, and then people were saying it's just people buying fireworks. And we never got to the bottom of it. And you could just run whatever conspiracy theory you want. But thankfully, there's been very few fireworks so far. So thank you, you little moon crickets, for not lighting those, I guess.
Yo. Oh, God.
People were coming with the hot take. People was just like, I remember people on Twitter was like, I seen white guys in SUVs driving up and distributing them to kids. And I was like, that does not sound at all.
I don't
like
know about
that happened.
This.
I don't think that happened. I don't think that happened. But you know,
like Ray didn't put crack in the hood. He didn't put fireworks in the hood.
Right. He didn't put a crack in the hood. Wasn't like there wasn't like a drop off and there was a sign on it like, hey, you Negroes sell this. You know what I mean? Like they worked their way in.
The niggas dropped a pallet on 125th and fucking Broadway. Like yo,
they were like take one and sell one. You're like, oh okay.
Oh,
right.
Okay. Got it. I guess we'll sell crack now.
Crackety, crackety.
Yeah.
But now thinking back, if the CIA was involved with selling crack, that means that definitely some rappers in the early 80s were CIA operatives. Any rappers that were making songs that were too positive about crack and selling crack. Some people have dared to say NWA was funded by the CIA.
Ooh, damn.
Let's take a look at that. Because remember, Eazy-E, did he not end up at the White House?
Yep, he did. After being like, fuck the police.
Interesting.
Then he got the germ.
Did he get the germ because of that? Damn, we are some high-level barbershop shit right now, bro.
Woo! Yo, these motherfuckers gave Eazy-E HIV, B. open your third eye. You don't understand.
Talking about selling crack. We at the level of the barbershop conspiracy theory where the barber turned off his hair. He turned off his clippers. He's like, hear you.
He's like, hold on.
He's like, word? Oh, word? Really? Oh, word? Because I seen a YouTube video. You know what? Let me bring it up. What's your government name on Facebook so I can link you? You're like, just no, nigga.
No. Please don't. Please don't.
I'd be like, no, you know me as D with the razor bumps. You're not going to learn my real name. Fuck that.
No, you don't need that. I do not need to be interfacing with you on any social media network at all.
Also, people, you're not supposed, in the hood, you're not supposed to know someone's government name until they either go to jail and you write to them or when they die. That's it.
Facts.
Other than that, you spend your whole life, 40 years, you down with your boy Little Tito. He die, you find out his name is Philip. You're like, oh, wow.
Oh, wow. That doesn't even make sense. It's Tito?
Like, my son Philip, you're like, Tito, Little Tito. Get up for Little Tito, man. He brought the heat, bro.
That was my guy.
Forever in our memories, Little Tito. Hey, yo, Tito.
Those that I call my friends.
Hey, yo, Tito. Also, getting older in the hood, it sucks now because, like, people be dying and not... Like, you was ready, like, niggas gonna die from gunshot wounds or dirt bike crashes and shit. Niggas be like, yo, this nigga died from prostate cancer. Oh, this nigga just had a heart attack. You're like, oh, shit. Damn. Like, that's how this nigga went out? Like...
That was it?
I'm like... Nigga, we survived shootouts. This nigga just died on his couch? Oh, okay. Oh.
Ew.
All right. Also,
that's corny.
I'm like, this
that's
nigga
the
died
worst thing that can happen is if you die and motherfuckers are like, ew, that was corny.
Yeah, you like...
He died mad nigga, corny?
I'm like, this nigga died at 39? For real?
What?
You're like, what? I guess. Or you just be on IG and somebody does like the wild, vague post. And I'd be like, yo, I can't believe, you know, we losing good ones every day. I don't know what's going on. And you're just like, I don't know who this person's talking about. Then in the comments, they'd be like, yo, rest in peace, Tito. You'd be like, the fuck, Tito died? And they'd be like, oh, I thought
when?
You knew. And you're like, no one told me this shit, nigga. And you got, then you look on the IG, you missed the memorial service. Niggas already got the fucking candles out.
The whole shit,
out.
The wake,
niggas
everything.
Niggas got those stupid laminated cards that say sleep in peace that if you have a real job, you can't wear. I'm like, yep. Bro, all right?
The family got the airbrush t-shirts.
I'm like, bro, can I get the sleep in peace card, I don't know, a smaller wallet size? Because I can't just wear this all day at my actual government job. So, man. You know.
Yo, fam, and they're why are they always, like, fucking 8x10? Like, they're like a
they're like
a piece of printer paper.
I'm just like, yo, what is it? And then they're like, yo, come through to the memorial service. Yo, we having it on blah, blah, blah at midnight. And I was like, that seems like the same location he got shot at. Correct?
Yeah.
They're like, yeah, we showing niggas we ain't scared. We ain't pussy. We still on the block. There. And I'm like, I'm not going to that shit.
No.
I'm like, Dr. Fauci.
That's dumb.
I'm like, Dr. Fauci said that this would be a Zoom. So, you know, send me a login.
Yeah. And make sure there's a password so I don't get Zoom bombed.
Because it's like, cool. Not, like, now I get it. Because now the niggas like, oh, you don't bust your guns? I was like, No. I'm on TV.
No, I don't.
How do I look busting guns? Nigga, I don't even got the fucking duck hunt gun. You know what I'm saying? Like, niggas is legit. Niggas pay taxes.
I was like, yo, dog, are you stupid? Like, I bought a house. Like, I can't be out here shooting niggas. Like, are you dumb?
Also, like, what's the end game there? I shoot someone. That I'm like, yeah, I got it. Now I got to go to jail? Now I'm going to be in jail because I shot someone? And like, well, I'm going to be like, yo, put the show on hold. I'll be back. Like,
yeah, that's not how 5 years. Hold me down.
Matter of fact, I'm just doing the show. I'm doing it over the phone, like Capone, on the first Capone Noriega album and shit.
Yo, sir, you know.
Yeah, what's up? Yeah, it's your boy Jesus Nice calling in from the island.
You know what I'm saying? It's your boy the Kid Mero. We live, you know what I'm saying? Thursday.
You know what I'm saying?
Thursday.
Actually, Thursday. Yo, we got Don Cheeto on the phone. We got a show tonight. Yo, let's start the show.
Let's get it.
Yo, man, I can't really see the video, so describe to me what's going on. It says in the email or something with some goats.
Yeah, so like right here in this clip right here, it's a goat. And he's
bah!
Like
Right. Goats go bah.
Yeah. Yo, he's like eating like a can.
And yeah, then, I'll eat like, him because I enjoy curry goat because I'm Jamaican. Lord of mercy.
You know the vibes. And he eats a can and then he's like and then he screams like a human.
All right, I gotta go because my phone time is up. I'll call you back in 10 minutes, all right? Just hold it down.
Bet. Yo, that shit's clicking.
Yeah, don't say nothing about my crimes.
All right, bet. Yo, be gay and do crime, my nigga. Stay up.
There you go. There you go. That's my tattoo on my chest. It's caused a lot of issues here inside prison.
That's our new shit now. Instead of when you like leaving with your boy and you be like, yo, stay up, my G. You be like, yo, stay gay and do crimes.
Stay gay and do crime, my G. Gang shit. My nigga, gang shit.
You know the fucking vibes. All right? Yo, my nigga, you out in these streets being gay and doing crime. And it's like, you know the vibes, big homie. I'm like, okay. Yo, for real, because on this block, yo, them niggas is straight over there, not over here, nigga. We stay gay. We do crimes.
That's right.
All right?
Y'all motherfuckers,
watch out.
Y'all niggas don't know.
Okay.
Y'all think y'all know, but y'all don't know. You know
y'all
what I'm saying?
I don't know. All right.
Ain't giving it up like us.
All right. Gay niggas over here, nigga. All right. Gay way. You're.
He's a gay way.
Like, yo.
Yo.
Also, what happened?
My God.
Two things that disappeared. First of all, shout out Jeffrey Toobin, who has gotten his job back after showing his dills on the Zoom. So,
fam,
shout out to that man.
I'm like, that shit is so wild to me because it's like, yo, how could you beat your meat in a work meeting? Like, oh, I get it. It was Zoom, whatever. Mm-hmm. But that just means that this dude is comfortable beating his meat around other people.
Yeah. Because he, you know what? It's like, and I'm going to get flamed for this. It's white privilege. He knew he'd get his job back. He knew there was no way he was going to stay fired. And if you go on Twitter right now, there are people who are just like, good for him. Good for him. Why should he have his life ruined for one mistake? But how many people were in jail for one mistake who never get a chance for little things? But you know what? If he wants to pull out his little pink meats and beat them digitally, who are we to stop him, you know?
Who are we to judge?
Who are we to judge? All right, if your man got is a verb. They're like, Mero, you're tubing. You're like, I'm sorry.
Oh my God, I'm sorry. Sorry. Let me adjust my camera. Sorry.
Let me tube. Like your man had the beat. Your man had the meat out. Your man had his tube out. Okay.
The tube out. He said the meat is on.
Your man was beating his meat. Michelangelo when the Ninja Turtles was like tubular. He was like,
yeah, totally tubular, dude. Yo.
Wow. Man, but he got his job back.
He came back and then he was just like, yo, my fault. Like, basically, right? Like, yo, my fault.
You gotta be a special person to just beat your meat in front of people and get your job back. Because I know for a fact, neither you or I could get our jobs back if we beat our meat in front of a...
Bro, are you kidding me?
We're done.
Fam, if either of us does it, yo, you could be on fucking Mars and I could be on Earth. And if I beat my meat in front of somebody, neither of us is working again, ever again.
We're done.
And vice versa. Like, we're fucked.
You got people like Jeffrey Toobin, Louis C.K. Niggas beat they meat. Like, niggas beat they meat every day. You be all right. I'm like, oh, okay. All right. Okay. Niggas
is
like, yo.
You be all right.
I beat my meat, now I'm breathing different. You know what I'm saying?
I'm walking different, you know what I'm saying? Doctor's saying I might not be the same ever again.
That's what happens when you beat. Do people forget that was the Big Noise album, Lifestyles of the Beat. Meat Beaters.
The Meat Beaters? Right?
Yeah.
Lifestyles of the Rich and Horny?
Lifestyles of the Rich and Horny. Oh, good times. Good times back when you could beat your meat.
Beat your meat.
Also, every time you Google him, that's the first thing that's going to come up. So every time you meet him, like imagine you on the Zoom, he's like Jeffrey Toobin. You're like, oh, wait a minute, Jeffrey Toobin for real? Toobin?
And that's the thing now. Like, any other person named Jeffrey Toobin, you're fucked, my guy. Because you're going to walk into every meeting, they're going to be like, Jeffrey Toobin? And then they're going to look at you twice, and you're going to be like, not that Jeffrey Toobin.
Not that one.
I'm Jeff
Toobin.
The other one, bro.
I'm
Jeffrey with a G.
Okay.
Like the giraffe.
You're Jeffrey with a G, because we're looking for Jeffrey who's curved like a J. So, you know.
Whoa!
Nasty. Sucio. You know the fucking vibes. So, it looks like what's going on now with the Brooklyn, as we write this, is tied 2-2 on the playoffs. Mm-hmm. Harden is injured, and I believe Kyrie got one with an injury.
Went down with an injury. You hate to see it. And that's one thing, too. I'm a hater, but I'm not like a physical hater.
Right. You never want to see someone injured.
Yeah. Never. Because I remember when it happened to Derek Jeter, and motherfuckers were cheering. And I was just like, you motherfuckers are scum.
You motherfuckers.
So I'm like, I'll root for a mother to go, I'll root for a motherfucker to go 0 for 30 and shoot 0%, but I won't root for a motherfucker to break his ankle or some wild shit like that. That's
right. That's always OD. Too far.
No. That's like if somebody was just like, yo, I hate Desus and Mero so much, I hope their fucking vocal cords disappear. So they can never make a fucking joke again. Ha 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 ha.
Damn. Shout out to the doc.
You know what I'm saying?
What's the formula? But yeah, like you said, we're not assholes like that. I would never root for an injury. That was one of the things that if you look back when we were saying if we wanted Kyrie on the Knicks, we were just like, if he stays healthy. And now I'm able to see we predicted it and people were like, you absolutely did not. And I'm like, boo, 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 whatever. I don't want to hear it.
La, 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 la. You're wrong. You're right.
Called it. I'm the Black Mac Francesa.
You're the Black Mac Francesa that says, I said that. Yeah, I said that. Yeah, I said that. And what?
Hey, Mons, give me another sweet tea. Yeah. Ow. But no, now it's an interesting game now because Brooklyn, you got a little pressure on you. You know what I'm saying? You haven't lost at home yet.
Uh-huh.
Is this going to be KD's breakout game? Are we going to see KD put up numbers that absolutely, once and for all, establish he is one of the most dominant scorers in NBA history? Or no.
Or not.
We shall see.
You know what I'm saying? Or does he pop up with two new burners? Actually, he's not even on the burner shit no more. He's like, yo.
Nah, he's right in his account.
He's like, yo, what's good?
I'll come right at you right now.
What up? Fuck you. I respect it too. And you know what's bad? I'm gonna keep it fucking. I'm a pure hater. He looks great. I thought, honestly, as a basketball fan, I thought, he's not gonna come back to 100%. You know what?
An Achilles tear, dog, is
mm-hmm. that's one of the worst fucking injuries you could ever get as a basketball player, dog. It severely limits your movement and shit. So it's just it's logical. It's fam. The only person that I've seen play through that many injuries is Kobe. You know what I'm saying? R.I.P. to the guy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I was just like, yo, this dude is not built like that. You know what I mean? He's 7 feet tall. It's not even haterism. It's it's just science. You're too big.
It's not haterism. You know what it is? Because I can fix what you just said. Here's the problem. You said you don't come back from an Achilles injury the same way. And to that, I would say you are wrong. In order to say that statement correctly, you have to say no Nick has ever come back from Achilles history the same way. Because we all seen it. Every other team, the person, they ripped both their ACLs. They'll never walk again. And 4 weeks later, he drops a 60 piece. Wow, you'll have to see it.
Meanwhile, unbelievable.
A Nick is he fractured his pinky in the offseason. He's retiring. He's done. Sorry.
He's done. He's
sorry.
Done.
Sorry. He's sorry. Sorry. Hate to see it.
We discovered he tore every tendon in his arm by that one pinky. Yeah.
They're like, look at Amari Stoudemire has no more ligaments in his body. You hate to see. I'm like, that's not even a thing.
How is that possible?
They're like, oh, you hate to see it. Melo has the Jedediah virus, which has just been found this morning. You're like,
what is that?
Is he playing or not?
Jedediah? Isn't that the Beverly Hillbillies?
I'm literally on Twitter. I'm searching Jedediah virus. It's just other Knicks fans. What the fuck is a Jedediah virus? And then Doris Burke is like, you hate to see Melo with the Jedediah virus. You also hate to see the work they're doing in the Brooklyn Nets. They're doing amazing. They are just flying through the schedule. What KD and Kyrie have done to bring this community together is just unstoppable. And you just love to see it.
I gotta agree with you there, Doris.
I'm just sitting at the TV. I'm like, more about the virus. More about the virus, y'all. Is it contagious?
Yo,
my
God. Yo. Oh, my God. I cannot. Oh, man. If these motherfuckers. Oh, I can't wait to see this L. I hope they take
it. Woo! Which well? The Brooklyn?
The Brooklyn L? Because I feel you on the make it to the finals and then take an L. Because it's like, yo, you almost got there. But I don't like, because I feel like Nets fans will be like, yo, but we made it to the finals, though. Y'all haven't made it to the finals since 1999. Yeah.
You guys can't see it right now because of the podcast. I just snatched the barbershop apron off my neck, and I'm like, this nigga's spitting. Okay? Actually, it was more dramatic. I have all the Noxzema on my face and a washcloth. Yeah. And I was like,
eyes are burning and shit. You're like, yo, this nigga's, yo, that's facts. That's facts. That's facts.
Also, this been on my face for 20 minutes. Where's my barber? He's in the front doing the wild freestyle. He's like, yo, don't beg for mercy. I'm Nancy Pelosi. He's like, boo.
Nigga,
come take this Noxzema off my face. What the fuck?
Yo, come on. I look like Sammy Sosa. Stop.
Hold up. I'm getting to the bridge. Yo. Gimme. All your fucking stimmies.
My face is burning.
I got the mad bitch. That bitch from Trini. My man. I got like 48 more bars. I'll be right there.
I love hip hop too, but yo, my face is on fire.
Yo, the boys run up and they ask me what I'm hiding, but I was cool because I got the phone number for Biden.
Okay, it's in my eyes.
Let me go. This bitch ass nigga burning from now.
I think I got under my contact.
Hold on. Let me ash this Newport.
That is my eye.
Oh, damn. This nigga just a wild bitch. Like,
oh my God.
Hold on. Let me re-microwave this dirty washcloth I've had on 7 people today.
So. Oh, hurry up, please. And can you rinse it? I think it has doodle on it.
Shit, my baby mama calling. What? What you? The kids spilled orange juice on my MPC? Nigga, I need that to make. Fuck that. I'm coming right now.
No,
I'll be right back, big man.
I'll buy you an NPC.
Nah,
I'm on Amazon right now.
It's a special one. Yo, my man, I'll be right back. You'll be all right.
No, it burns.
Man, you already light skin. You all right? You look like DJ Envy. You'll be okay. All right, gotta go. Sponsored by Noxzema.
A hood barber will handle all their business except their business.
Exactly. Because a hood barber, you just get your hair cut and like you're not really paying attention. You're on your phone and he'll ask you a question. You'd be like, you listening? You'd be like, oh, no. He'd be like, I was talking to my girl and like she was saying that China's manipulating currency. How do you feel about that? Matter of fact, I got her on FaceTime. You want to talk to her? You'd be like, How did it become
part of your relationship? I don't want to do this.
Well, shout out to my old barber. He was like, yeah, so we're doing karaoke night. It's going to be Tuesday at 7. And I was like, who does karaoke on Tuesday at 7? Like,
in a barbershop?
And then he was like, if you pay $25 now, you can lock in for what songs you want. And I was like, what? I got to pay $25 for songs at karaoke night on Tuesday at 7? My nigga.
Sir.
I was like, if anything, I feel like you don't respect me, my nigga.
Like, no, you definitely don't. You left me with my face burning with Noxzema. Now you trying to charge me $25 to lock in Hey Ma?
So you want to do Hey Ma 3 times? I'm like, yeah. Put Old Town Road in between that for the kids.
Yeah, fuck it.
Like, he's like, it's also gonna be a birthday party. I'm like, how? What kid's birthday is at 7 p.m. on a Tuesday?
Mine's.
The kid's a Gemini. I'm like, what?
I don't know. That makes no logical sense at all.
So. Because I know the kid's baby mama and she's a cook. So like we basically have the first floor in Red Lobster for an hour. So just come through.
Oh, so the first floor at Red Lobster.
Yeah, but don't make it hot because they don't know that we have the first floor. So just come in like a normal, like, and then she'll seat you in like a special area. But don't go in there asking about like hookah and shit like that. Like we got it under the table. So it's gonna be cool. So,
okay.
Saying. Matter of fact, if you want hookah, it's gonna be $50 a pull. So I think like the average person does four pulls for hookahs. That's gonna be like $200. I know, nigga, I see you at the Mayweather fight. I know you got that, big man. Yo, this nigga getting money over here.
No, it's called the kid Mero,
but his money growing.
No.
Ha ha.
No. What? I'm not getting money.
Are you paying for everyone's haircuts? Oh shit. What a step. Yo. No. They need to meet more niggas like you.
I said the 10-year-old, I said I would pay for his shape up.
That's what's up. Yo, my man Mero was like, yo, kids, Mero said he's paying for your child support. Yo.
No, Nah. I mean, what I meant was, like, y'all could have, like, my kids' lightly used old stuff. I don't have money for that.
Yo, so, I just want to talk to you. Yo, Mero, you a big inspiration to me and my family. You guys through the pot, like, through the pandemic.
Oh, man, thank you. I appreciate like, that, bro.
Laughing every night with you and yeah. what you and Desus do on the podcast, on the show. What you did with Obama was good. That shit with Fauci. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what
the
we
fact
do.
That
Bodega Boys,
the fact, the fact that you a New York nigga, you know, you a Bronx nigga. Now you out in Jersey, you getting money. You got deer in your backyard and shit. Like, nigga, that just made me. That shit is so beautiful, man. That shit is so beautiful. And I see you shining with chains and shit. And I just like,
oh,
run that
wow.
shit, my nigga.
Wow.
Yeah.
See?
You know what it was.
I knew this was going to happen.
Knew what it was when you signed up.
I knew what it was when I signed up. That's why I wore the fake chains that I bought at the mall to come here. And I left the real ones at the crib. So you can have these.
Okay.
And you're going
to
be very...
No, actually, no. I'm taking it. We're going to Weehawken and we're going to test them. You're coming with me. And if they're not real, we're killing you. So,
oh, wow.
Maybe you didn't hear the... Yeah. Shit. Matter of fact, let me do that a third time so there is a bullet in the chamber.
Oh,
okay, now we're good.
Okay. All right. So I guess I well, you know what? This is a pretty lit way to die, so fuck it. I mean, you know. I guess.
This nigga's ready to die. That's what I come in. I was like, oh, where? Oh, where? You like, you here to save me? I'm like, nah, niggas want to talk about real hip hop. Ready to Die was an amazing album by the lyricist, Biggie Smalls. And it was just like, oh my God. It was just an amazing song.
It's a masterwork.
Can we talk about the masterwork of, you know what? You know what? If you're kidnapping Mero, kidnap me. We'll just keep this conversation going. So, you know, just amazing times. We're just doing amazing stuff.
Real hip hop.
This nigga just kissed his wife. Okay. This nigga loves his wife. I'm disgusted.
Disgusting. You hate to see it.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Police! Help! Police! Help! Police! Help! Help!
I can't do this podcast anymore. This thing got love in his life. He got love. He got support. He got wife. Wow.
Actually, you hate her guts.
Okay.
You know, you're just a joke. I mean, you're really just stupid. I mean, it's not even clever or funny or anything. It's just dumb.
That's just right.
For those of you who were not at Miro's wedding, that was his vows. He was like, yo, shy.
Mero loves his wife, and Mero is the new Chance the Rapper, but not like that.
I gotta be like the anti-Chance and be like, I hate my wife. Ah!
You gotta do I Love My Wife, but like the bachata version. So it's like the wild sensual. Like the shit that niggas that love their wife, they grind up on other bitches too. Like, yo. I love my wife, but she doesn't look like you.
Yeah. Hey, Robbie, I wish if I could have more than one wife, you would be another one.
And the DJ gets on the mic and is like, hey, all my people out there, you know what we do? Be gay and do crime.
B.G.D.C, we out here.
You know the fucking vibes? Yo, but you know the fucking vibes. Your boy Deez is nice, a.k.a. Young Chipotle. A.k.a. Pockets stay fat like Cheerio. A.k.a. Pockets stay fat like here we go. See, sorry, that was a little
pitchy?
I mean, that was a little soul for y'all because I want to let y'all know that the AKAs, they move forward.
Yes.
And they're not stagnant. Yes. And I think I need to let y'all know something about a boy we know by the name of one Tyrio. Oh. The Pockets have indeed stayed fat like Tyrio. And Tyrio has said, enough is enough. Y'all gonna put some respect on my name because I am a rap legend.
Yo, Tyrio's out here. He's in the lab.
Did you see Tyrio in a lab? You see him making it happen.
He's locked in. He's locked in. Listen, I seen it. He's locked in. Yo, he's in there doing ad-libs. He's on a step stool, hitting the mic hard. Bars.
Well, when you get a chance, be sure to check out Tyrio's page. Check out his bars. I think we might have to do a reunion. It's coming soon. We might have to get back with
we
the
have
guard.
To. We have to.
I have to bring it back full circle. But yo, listen. It's Slow, but I might know you, but Young Day Party, Young Hot Take, DJ Fuego, ooh. Mr. Nando's, with the Rondo, Milner was at the Navete Cuatro, Mikhail going off the Juve boss, MC, Little Gunga P.
What?
Little Gunga P. I'm pulling up from 40, which is shorty.
Woo!
Are you upset because I'm pulling up from 40, which is shorty? Huh?
Huh? How does that make you feel?
Do you feel bad about that? Do you feel like less of a man? Because I have your shorty, and I have your shorty out here, and I'm pulling up with her.
Huh? Huh?
And now your shorty's being wild thirsty to get on the guest list, so we get in for open bar. And I'm like, damn, who raised you, Ma?
Wow.
You ain't, you're not used to nothing nice. Wow.
Hey, yo, act like you've been here before.
Let me save you, Ma. Yo, leave those Chinese slippers inside the car, bro. Like, come on. Yo, Ma, you can't wear sneakers to this club. I'm sorry.
Nah.
AKA, don't talk to me in the Uber pool. I don't know you. And if I keep calling an Uber pool and you're the driver, be like, you're drunk. Don't just leave me alone. If I keep locking the doors, like, don't let anyone else in, bro. They're like, Jesus, Uber pool hasn't existed since pandemic started. I was like, yeah, I don't want to pick up anyone else. It's just me and you, bro. It's just me and you. Let's fucking go. Listen, the original by Plus One got Plus One. So don't make a fuss. And listen, bro, like, listen. Like, bro. I'm just out with the town with Shorty right here. Like, you're really going to ask for her phone number for contact tracing? Like, bro, I'm not going to, after this, I'm not going to see her again. So, you're making it hot. Like, I don't want to have that digital footprint. So, you know. Oh, you need my number? It's 8325 or whatever Billy's Girls is. You know what I mean? Jesus Rossi and the Jamaican Jew, Jermaine Avocado Toast, Young Pod, the Ghost of Mufasa, Young Chakuni without the Coonery, a.k.a. Chili Limon, left-handed reliever for the Yankees. Okay?
Oh.
Loke.
Papi.
Looking at the Yankees, maybe they need me to come back from the dead. They're looking a little bad.
Yeah, that's no good. Not right now, it's no good in Yankee town.
I ain't anyone to say, but, you know, the Yankees are really bad when they have a lot of white players, and this is what's going on right now. And
I just want to say, you know, it's a problem. They got to listen to CeCe Sabathia. He know what he's talking about.
Exactly. Two phone dones. DJ Machina, Jace Chuckles, Stanley Cups, the Human Dr. Bonner's Label, Dilute.
Woo!
Leonardo DiTrapio. Mr. 240p, because I like my Pinot blurry.
Oh, yeah.
Not too blurry, but blurry enough that I can identify people. Because, you know, every now and then you see, like, a net video girls, and you're like, what's her name?
Top video player today.
Oh, she wants to be a history teacher. Tell me more.
Oh, the caption is just, what's her name? I need to know her name.
Okay. The other caption is, whatever, bro, you still smash. And you're like, oh, that's true. DJ Woolite, aka listen to Watch FM. Yo, shout out to, we gave her props earlier in the show. Shout out to the LGBTQIA legend and New York legend, Young M.A.
Yeah.
You know the fucking vibes.
Yeah, they hate, but they broke.
Oh,
but they broke. And when it's time to pop, they are no
way.
Yeah, I'm pretty, but I'm loco.
Yeah, I'm loco.
The loud got me moving slow-mo. Hey, yo, Tweety, where the hoes, bro?
Where the hoes, bro?
Hey, yo, Keys, where the hoes,
bro?
Shout out to Young M.A.
Yeah.
Remember that ooh. Summer? Ooh, that song held us down. Also, shout out to when I gave her the wild, hard dap at Vice when she was on the show. And she was like, yo, chill. And she was like, yo, chill, I'm a girl, bro. I was like, yeah.
Yo,
I brought it in heavy. I was like, what's up, my dude?
Yo,
like,
but that's what it be like that, though, in the hood, though. Like, when the studs in the hood are more thugged out than
they
the niggas.
Like, they niggas. Motherfucking Vaz. Yo, the Curry Goat, Dean Spicer, Jamal Hasburn, the Bronx Lean Dion, Ray and Nephew's Nephew, the Moreno, you can't contain him, the Human Meme, Word to Ja, Young Aaron, the Racist Provocateur, Henrik Budkos, Nelson Bandela, Sergio Can't See Me, Vladimir Buffin, the Human Word, there's melting in your mouth.
Wow.
Mr. Bex on deck saying Ricky Tiki Scrobby, Greg Popovich, Morris which is Chestnut, Mahatma Gandhi, not Maccabee, but I got the cucumber, the juices are pressed, but your boy never is.
Never.
I am the art, damn it. The Dundada Ganoush, no more cup of noodles, the Prince of Peckham, the Fashion Nova Casanova, we made cents, 5 cents, 10 cents, dollar, forget the small change, give me big money.
Why?
The only anthem I salute is Dipset, Mr. Sagger, catch me at square one, top left, Mans is Marv. Choose it, holy cow. Mr. Stoffos, all I do is count checks and jerk off. We got OJ Purple Stuff Soda and
it's me, Sonny D, bro. Also, I expired in the beginning of the pandemic. You should really throw me away. I'm like old as shit, bro. Like, come on. I've been here a year. I mean, David Uriman. These expensive. These are red bottles. These are bloody shoes. Smokeem Noah, Andrew Kunanen, aka the Junior Energy God Junior. Come sit down, palm me. Charger. Ooh. Call me Petco because I got your bitch on freeze. The topic of gossip and psyops, child to the 11791. We're going to fucking rule you in lacrosse, bro. Okay?
That's right.
Fuck you, bro.
Dude.
And fuck them whore. Fuck them sluts in Babylon, all right?
Yeah, I don't even fuck need that, to, bro. All
right?
Meet me later on fucking PlayStation, bro. 1v1 me, bro.
Date, bro. Didn't even know, bro. Yo, bro, let's take a fucking train into the city, bro. My father's a finance, bro. All these little brown people are going to work for me in the future.
That's right. Bro, it's worth three polos at once.
Let's go, bro. Sayasa till I die. AKA Grandpa Joe, because when you see Charlie, you see me. Don't touch that golden ticket. It's your man, Dead IDs. It's more than the sheriff. It'd be a shame if I started stealing again, because I haven't stolen the whole pandemic. And, bro, the only thing I'm stealing is some look from your beautiful blue eyes, Sheriff. Wow. Mr. Top of that street, easy like a bad breezy. Black, I'm easy. Please believe me. The black Asiatic addict. We'll crack your back like a bat. We'll crack your back like automatic craft man. Mr. Lumber in a mess marina with a fresh Mr. Bean and a cold demeanor. Mr. Bean and a fresh marina and a fresh Mr. Bean and a cold demeanor. Mr. Lumber in a mess marina with a fresh Mr. Bean and a cold demeanor. Mr. Lumber in a mess marina with a fresh Mr. Bean and a cold demeanor. That's a better song than Astronaut on the Ocean. Okay? I'm gonna put that out there. Like, I feel like Mr. Lumber in a mess marina in an ocean.
Yeah.
It doesn't really work.
It works. It's also less racist.
Fresh marina and a cold demeanor in the ocean. Shout out to Dance Monkey, which I did some research. It is, the name of the performer is Tonesis and I. And the song, which you pointed out, because you were like, it sounds like a racist song. But she made the song after busking, you know, when they sing on the street for money. And she was singing on the street and she was having like a terrible day. Like shit was not going well. She was not getting money. And people just kept coming up and was like, we heard about you, perform for us. So literally what you were saying, they were like to her, Dance Monkey. But if you listen to the song, she switches from Dance Monkey to Dance Monkey. You get it?
Yo.
Layers.
Yo,
so,
see?
You know, fuck there you go. Sheet mask killer. Ella. No one could be Illa. The Black Zach Morris, Support Morris. Young KPI. It's your boy Personal DJ, aka the Peloton. JPI Queso. Inspector Terror Deck. Nickelback Sarkozy. James Vaxton. You know what I'm saying? Dumb shot it up. AKA your problematic bait. It's not a secret family if you only allow them to get one shot for the vaccine and tell them mistruth from Facebook so they don't get the second shot so you still control them.
Yeah. That's right. You know what I'm saying? And now it's time for you, boy. The Kid Mero, a.k.a. the Human Durag, a.k.a. Donovan McDab, a.k.a. Curve Gotti, a.k.a. Tris Khalifa. You know what I'm saying? That's right, baby. A.k.a. Skirt Loader. Jump the curb, hit your motherfucking dog, and keep it moving. Ask me if I give a fuck. The leash was less than 6 feet long. I'm here to protect everybody, okay? I don't fucking, baby. I fucking, man, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? No need to check the guest list because we have full capacity, baby. They starving to let motherfuckers in. They letting me in right after the dope feed. Ha-ha! You know what I'm saying? So we good. I didn't even care. I came with 10 dudes and no women. We had to shoot this shit up. A.K.A. CC Dab out here. Get me in my basement doing highly concentrated puffs of THC out of my Puffco peak. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Tiger Backwoods, smoke a 3 grand blunt and hit you with this 9 iron. A.K.A. get into the shmoney and smoke. It's your boy Goldman Schmack. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Mesh Montana. I went from roaches in my cupboard to kois in my pond. I think I did okay for myself. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Hey, I got my kids coming out of the bullpen for the Yanks because we need help. You know what I'm saying? And also, I'm the motherfucking dad of the year. You know the fucking vibes. A.K.A. Ben Smack Biombo. A.K.A. Diego Maradona. A.K.A. Dick in your paper Motumbo. You don't come in this pussy no more. This pussy belongs to me. No. Let me walk that back. The pussy belongs to you. I'm sorry. I must receive enthusiastic consent before I proceed. Thank you, my queen.
Look at the girl.
Look at it. You love it. A.K.A. Bottle Santana is so smooth. I fall asleep at the wheel and crash a Civ car. You know what I'm saying? It don't even matter because it's a PT Cruiser. You know what I'm saying? I'm just crashing shit and leaving and keep it moving. You know what I mean? Who cares? A.K.A. the Dominican Dundada Declan Daddy. You know what I'm saying? Catch me at Altina eating fish with platanos. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. I'm going to swipe my card again. There's definitely money on it. Stop trying to play me. This is a gold card. know what I'm saying? Before I call your manager that DVRs a show and embarrass you. You know what I'm saying? Don't worry about how high I am. Just put the motherfucking peanut butter and jelly combo goober in the fucking bag and keep it moving. And don't ask me why I got 10. All right? That's my business. I'm not trying to be outside right now. It's a pandemic. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Romeo Santos. Tu favorito, mami. So zany. Ooh, let me black out. They call me the K.O.B. King of booty eating. You feel me? You bring your titi around, I eat that ass. So nasty. A.K.A. Tom Brady got my more balls more deflated than Bobby Kraft. A.K.A. Lionel Dutchy. Hello. Is it weed you're looking for? I can see it in your eye that you've been coronavirus. So I cannot share this blood with you. You know what I'm saying? We smoking personals until 2023 at least. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? A.K.A. Feel the ass, Tyson. I want to explore your cosmos. My consensually, of course. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. A little snoozy vert. First nigga to tap out on live. Been social distancing before Rona. A.K.A. Fire Now Messi, MVP of Gelato. A.K.A. Gisenio Benningfield. I gotta get some sticks. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. I'll open your medicine cabinet. You know who the fuck it is, boy. Be boy. It's the Sandman. A.K.A. Rico Sabroso. A.K.A. Joe Hookah. I dare you to spar with me at Mama Sushi. We are 110 capacity. You know what I'm saying? I don't know how you go above 110%, but they did it. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to them. A.K.A. Baby Dude 425. Niggas got garbage down the way. A.K.A. Nino Brown. Shut the car down. A.K.A. Professor Hornell West teaching socio studies at your local CUNY university. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. The motherfucking I met Mike Francis. I'm never gonna fail. AKA live harassing patrons outside MSG waiting for the next season to start yet again. It's this Streamhouse DVB doing all his greatest hits like I wanna be the one your DD is fucking and Dope Sick Love. Don't let me leave. You know what I'm saying? AKA if you see me at Target higher than a cold brontosaurus sack on a 10-foot diving board, you know what I'm saying? Please approach me like a motherfucking earth-side mammal because I might react erratically and you won't like that. You know what I'm saying? Play dead. You know what I'm saying? AKA, listen, mate, I gotta tell you this all the time. It happens a lot. It's only two rock stars left, mate. The Bodega Boys, of which I am one. The plants ain't sleeping ever in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed on Dreamer, dipping my blood in the PCP cause I miss the old days. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Tom Petty, the Ball Breakers, baby, cause when you see me in the Zoom, baby, I'm free. Free bowling, I'm just letting them hang. A.K.A. I sold fake lean to your favorite SoundCloud rapper. He's high off lens cleaner and the rest of the shit that was left in my contact case when I took it out. You know what I'm saying? hey kids, it's Benzo the Clown. Hire me for your kid's birthday party. I'll show up to your kid's party after it's over. Or maybe late, whatever, who cares? We're just opening up. While I figure these things out and guess what the fee is, Mr. Fun Fun here will entertain your children while I count this money.
Hey kids, I don't want to see vaccine cards, but if you have like credit cards or anything from your parents, that'd be cool too, and like their IDs. Like, Mr. Fun Fun's been down bad, and I really need some money real quick. And, like, I know Craigslist is closed. I can't do hand jobs, so I need you.
Oh, Mr. Fun Fun! Did you have the visa?
I got two golden cards. Let's get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, let's get the fuck out of here. Let's get the van. Happy birthday, Johnny. Bye. A.K.A. You know what time it is, papi. Time for you to turn on your SAP. And he translate to it. Porque coño, oye, que lo que voy a llegar, el hijo de Titi FIFA, coño, hermano, loco, todo bajando con la papa reprendida, no me dejo todo, que palo, que te tumba coco, mamá huevo, la palo, la glasa, 24 quilates, loco, y no sé, estamos cavando, alta gama, nuevo rico, traga champaña, mucho marico, y no sé, más cadenas que una fábrica de bicicletas, tú sabes que lo que. You know what I'm saying? Shout out la casa Showtime, shout out Cash Out, shout out Hasan y C, el ingeniero, el que pone la fucking nota. Shout out Desus, buena la nota jamaiquina, el número uno, number one. He's gonna be the president of Jamaica one day, prime minister. Lo dije yo y va a seguir. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Victor Marte, el papi de la ley de 24 kilates de Milena. You know what I'm saying? Shout out nena de bodega, dai la planta, la más dura, la insuperable. Shout out mi presidente Pío, secretario de defensa, activo con cañón, avísame que lo suelto. Llegó mi mano freaky, 12 años poniendo su boca floja, yo no concuro con palomo, tú sabes que lo que. Que descanse paz, mi mano sexo y mi mano chawi. ¿Qué está la casa? Bueno, no te quedes en la casa, que estamos fuera, pero lávate la mano y ponte tu mascarita y ponte tu vacuna. Vacuna. In Spanish, vacuna. In English, vaccine. Do it. Now, you have to do it. Go outside to be outside. Okay, this has been public service announcement at the Bodega Boys Podcast. Me quité, ya. Pow.
You know the fucking vibes. Episode 244, another one sponsored by Cash App. Let's say, keep washing your hands. It's another podcast. Enjoy this one. Let's do it slow so you enjoy it. And listen, we back when we out. We out. Peace. Holla.